Gio, what's it been like? You know, because coming into the season, a lot of people said, oh, well, the weakness of this defense might be the D-line. But, like, you guys have been a strength of this team so far. What's it like working under Bo playing under Bo Davis?
It's honestly been a privilege to be under a guy of his resume, where he's been, who he's developed, everything thus far. You know, we knew that coming into this season that everyone's eyes were going to be on us. And I think we've answered that fairly well in terms of the interior D-line. But, yeah, shout out to Coach Bo for sure. That's my guy.
On the D-line, Ahmad Bro, freshman, he's been really stepping up. What have you seen from him, you know, especially being so young?
Right. No, Ahmad is definitely eager to learn. He's young. He's hungry. Even a lot of the times, I think, just being in the college football world for so long, freshmen who get put in a position to play early, that could be a strong ego boost, but that's definitely not the case for him. I think he's really stepped into the role well and ultimately just been eager to learn.
You guys got a Vanderbilt coming into town. You know, they have a dual threat quarterback. It's kind of been a weakness for you guys. What other challenges does Vanderbilt pose for you guys?
I think, honestly, every single week we try to just come in with a new mindset and a clean slate, if you will. We're not really trying to warp on the past. We're trying to execute our game plan in terms of what Coach Baker has planned for us and kind of just do it to the best of our ability. You know, we're not really wrecking on the past.
Great opportunity, obviously, to finish the season at home with two victories. How's the mindset kind of been in the locker room trying to, you know, pick it back up after the three-game skid?
Right. You know, we're 6-1 a couple weeks ago, and we're on top of the world, and everyone's, you know, telling us how good we are, and then we lose three in a row, and we're back. So we kind of just try to stay away from the media in a way and kind of just keep our best foot forward. We know we have two more opportunities at home for us to end the season on the right note. And I think our approach in the locker room, we're just trying to keep it together, keep everybody composed, and not try to look so far as much ahead, but look at what the opportunity, what we have in front of us right now.
So far this year, Vanderbilt's been a team, likes to run the ball, likes to control the clock. Mm-hmm. You know, coming into the game against Florida, they wanted to do that as well, but I thought you guys did a pretty good job stopping the run. You know, what have you kind of learned from that Florida game that you guys can carry over into Vanderbilt?
Yeah, I think we knew going into Florida week that they're going to try to run the ball and try to establish that run game. And I feel like we answered that call well. They had one breakout run, I think, that put them over 100 yards later in the third or fourth. But up until that point, we had like 50 yards rushing. I don't know on how many carries, but I think we answered that really well. That's obviously going to be another thing this week that we're going to have to really just dig our boots in the ground and chop away at that. I don't think it's anything much more than that. I just think we need to stay focused on that.
You just said you're kind of avoiding the media. Has it been kind of hard for you guys? Or anything, you know, especially avoiding, you guys have been the talk of like national media with this three-game losing skid. Has it been kind of hard to kind of put behind you guys?
I think I'm going to do my job to the best of my ability. I don't really care what the score is. You can see me first quarter, fourth quarter. I'm going to go.
I guess overall, what's your experience been like transferring down here from Wisconsin?
Yeah, nevertheless, obviously it's not the exact way our season we wanted it to go, but I'm just beyond blessed that everyone down here welcomed me and gave me an opportunity, and everything's been great. You know, I love football. I love Coach Bo. I love everything that this has been. Obviously, I wish I could have went a different way, but I'm grateful.
Yeah, I got to ask you, would you say there's a big difference, like, atmosphere-wise with the SEC compared to the Big Ten, like, atmosphere-wise?
Yeah, I think driving into the towns of the games you're going to be playing in, that's probably the biggest thing that you notice. Because when you're on the field, you're in the game, you're locked into the game, but, like, just the amount of people that are flipping you off or whatever it is. It just means more in SEC, for sure.
Camp Randall at night's pretty cool, but how does it stack up against the night game down here?
Damn, y'all just trying to get me in trouble. Camp Randall at night is definitely electric. I don't think just 84,000 compared to 105,000, it's not quite comparable. And it's in the SEC, and those games have you know, everyone in the country is watching. I know Wisconsin just had a night game against Oregon. It looked electric, but I don't think it's quite the same.
Any more guys? Any more?
I guess for people maybe in your position this upcoming offseason, what would your pitch to them be if they're considering coming to play at LSU like you were?
Got a good fan base, playing in the best conference in college football, in the best stage in college football, the best coaches in college football. Like, nothing about how this season has gone has changed my perspective on LSU at all. Every single game that we have lost, with the exception of the Alabama game, came down to a couple minor mistakes that did not go our way.